If you want to see the list of POs which are having hold, we will do for our identification also NB and 5230. And I will take my vendor only. GKV3, I will run anything. And PO. Okay. Material, I have some materials. 214. And the people. 100. And giving my plant CKP1. Okay, I just decided to hold it. Okay, PO has system has generated the number, but which is in hold. Or else we can create one more PO with some error also. We can keep it to hold. Just given my vendor and material same. Okay, I have not given anything plant and all. Just I got some urgent work. I have hold it. Okay. Now I want to get the list of POs which are in hold. We will use the standard our list POs document ME2N. I will give my plant GKP1 and go to this dynamic selections. This dynamic selections holding got two header. One is the header and item. Almost all the fields will be captured here. And if you just come down in this, we have a field called incomplete. Okay. Incomplete purchase order is not yet created. Okay, just to go click on this incomplete. Then select the option yes. Okay, now execute it. See, there is a PO which is in incomplete status, and also we have put the hold. We are getting the which incomplete which is having the hold. This is the perfect option for us. When you go to the incompleteness, see here incompleteness is there. This will be the exact one if you want to identify. I was just about to check that what difference between incomplete and incompleteness. See, this is incompleteness. When you go to this incompleteness, we have a different option. Document saved as complete or document is parked, document hold. Okay, we have a hold option here and just execute it. Okay, you will get the list of POs which are having hold.
Yeah, this is through ME2N.
Yeah, ME2N document header and coming to incompleteness. Where is that incompleteness? Yeah, this is the incompleteness. And remove the plant and all, you will get all the POs which are having document and hold. And we can give GKP1 to NTP1. Whatever you have. Okay, you will get all the POs which are having the hold function. If you want to get from the tables also, you can get from EKKO table. The same option which we have seen the dynamic selections, you have to select the park hold. Okay, the document is on hold, and for 1000 company code, whatever you want to see, if you click on the number of entries, so there are 8 documents which are on hold. Okay, these are the POs which were kept as a hold. Like that, we can get. If you want to get from the table, we will get from EKKO table, and if you want to get from ME2N. This is the way how we are getting from the dynamic selections. See, for example, you have come to table EKKO and there are certain fields are visible. You want to make it visible of some other field. Okay, let's go to settings and click on fields for selection. Wherever which was marked, those will be visible to you. For example, you want to vendor also you want to visible in the input. Okay, then you have to select vendor and click on continue. Then see vendor field has come. Like that we can give the same logic for output also. After you get the output also, if you want to add or delete any fields and all that, you can do it. Account assignment category we are seeing in the purchase order. Okay, we have different kind of account assignment categories ME23N, and if you take any PO, which is item category, which will decide the type of procurement, which we cannot create a new one. Okay, SAP whatever the given, it we will use it. We cannot create a new one. Okay, now coming to account SMM category, we mainly use blank as a standard, which will give you the stock to your warehouse. Okay, and another, there are some important things. If you can see asset, if they want to treat a material as an asset, not an expense. What is the difference between expenses and asset? If you buy gold with your money, it's an asset. If you buy a movie ticket, it's an expense. Even TV, it's like an expenses only. Mobile is an expenses. We mean because the reusability or resale is very less. If you buy a bike, it's an expense, but it's an asset. We can call it as, many people treat it as an asset. How your company is dealing. Your Pizza Hut is buying some 10 bikes. That is an asset for them because their business is going on and resale. How do they want to deal? Because every material, we cannot say it is an asset, it's an expense. Okay, I'm doing a marketing. Okay, I'm doing my marketing job. Bike is required for me. Then bike is an asset for me. Okay, I treat my bike as an asset. But I'm a software engineer. My bike is an expenses because I go with cab and all only for my entertainment purpose and I'm using the bike. Okay, how your company is dealing the respective products. But general things we can tell, like movie tickets, going to hotel, these are all our expenses. And buying AC, maybe may have some resale, you can treat as a asset. How your company is dealing, they will use that asset. And a cost center, each department we create as a cost center. And if you buy the respective materials, there will not be any stock directly. That respective thing will be loaded on that cost center. Okay, certain kind of small materials, functions you are doing, and some get-togethers you are doing, and the Christmas celebrations you are doing in the company. For all those things, we give as a cost center. The respective expenses directly loaded on cost center, and also vehicle hiring, painting activity. For all those things, 100% it will be expenses only because you cannot make it a stock, right? Like I have done 10 floors painting as a stock MMB, it won't be right. Paint we can deal in a stock. Cages and all, cages are letters and all, but work and all we will, expenses will be loaded on cost center. There is a project system if you use, the P is a consumption and Q, project stock we can maintain, how we are maintaining that. These account assignment categories we can create, how many you want to create and where do you create, just we will go SPRO and reference IMG. Material management, purchasing, see what kind of requirements will make you to create a new account assignment category. I'm going to explain. See, then account assignment here, the first is maintain account assignment categories. See, whatever you created, our important thing, cost center, which we use mainly, just I will explain you. See what kind of things we are keeping here. The first is whether it is a consumption posting or stockable, what kind of thing, consumption, because whatever, there will not be any stock. There is a material 1, 2, 3, 4, you are giving blank, then 1, 2, 3, 4 stock will come in MMBE, but if you give K, it will directly consume. You cannot see the stock in MMBE. And here you can see some parameters, goods received, GR non-validated, invoice received. Can you see that? These things will automatically come to your PO. See invoice receipt indicator. Okay. Which is coming automatically. And if you come to delivery tab, goods received, GR non-validated, blank. Okay. Whatever the details, everything, these details come to PO automatically because of this. And when you use cost center K, see, you are making cost center as a mandatory entry. Are you observing that? Because of this entry, system will ask you to enter the cost center. Okay, if you are using, for example, project and all, we make the respect to WBS element as a mandatory and optional. Those things we can maintain here. And what is the use of creating the new account assignment? Because in our projects we have used that cost center with GR, that is K, okay, cost center with GR, because goods received we kept as a mandatory. Now we have saved it. I want to create a new one. I think I have already created in some one of the sessions. See, cost center, no GR. I created by keeping the GZ as a name. What I have done, cost center, see, I have removed this goods receipt. Then goods receipt won't come as a tick automatically at the time of PO. This means I don't want to do the goods receipt. I want to give cost center, but I don't want to do the goods receipt. That's why for that we will keep this as a new account SMM category. Name we will give cost center no GR, but in configuration I will remove this goods receipt tick mark. Then when I create a PO, I will show you the difference between these two. ME21N, I am creating a material, and okay, I am giving my material also, giving my plant quantity 100. See, account SMM category K I am giving. What kind of things are happening? System is asking cost center. Why? Because we make it as a mandatory. And coming to invoice tab, invoice receipt has come automatically, and delivery goods receipt tick has come because of K. Now I want to do same another item, but I want to keep it as a Z. Now click on check button. Okay. Just come to item 2. See what happened here. Goods receipt tick was not there because in configuration we have not kept it. Goods receipt tick was there for item 1, but for item 2 tick was not there. This kind of if you want to create for certain material they don't want to do the GR, then they are asking, business is saying like, see, for a list of some materials, what I am doing, whenever I create the material, I don't want to do GR. I am coming to this delivery tab and removing this tick mark. Sometimes users are forgetting to remove the tick mark. It's a very painful thing. Please do something. That is the requirement has come to you. As a consultant, what we do, we create a new account SMM category, cost center, no GR, and I will remove this tick mark. I will tell user, whenever you create PO for your materials for which you don't want GR, use account SMM category GZ. For your materials which you want to use the GR, use K. I have done in the naming itself, I have done K cost center with GR, Z cost center no GR or without GR, because they don't have to know about the configuration and all. Users, what do they know? Cost center with GR, cost center without GR. They have two functionalities. Without GR, they will assign Z. With GR, they will assign K. But in the backend, as a consultant, what we have done, for Z, we have removed this tick mark, and for K, we kept the tick mark. But if you see blanket procurement, when you give item category B, see, blanket procurement is very easy. You can run normal also. What system will do, directly we will do no GR concept because the GR is not required. What kind of things we use? Blanket procurement, payment of rent, okay, your factory day celebrations. You are going to celebrate some 30 lakhs budget you have spent for the factory day celebrations. All employees, families are get together and all those things. For that, okay, how many paper cups we have bought and how many chairs we have. Okay, how many vehicles we are hiring, all those things, goods received and all, not required. Directly you can create like this. What you do, GKB5, GKB1, anything we can do it, just a vendor, and purchase organization, okay, account SMM category K and item category B. Okay, B is a limit, we use this. Okay, what kind of thing? Factory day celebrations. Okay, nothing, only factory day celebrations we will give. For which plant you are going to create? ठीक है, पी वन फॉर दिस लिमिट इज मैंडेटरी। ओके, ओवरऑल लिमिट हाउ मच यू आर प्लानिंग टू स्पेंड, सम 30,000, 300,000, ओके 30 लैक्स, ओके कॉस्ट सेंटर जीके। कॉस्ट सेंटर इज what is the expected value, just you can write almost similar to that, the same thing you are expecting also, overall limit and expenses. Okay. Create a PO on vendor, let me take a reference of something, ZKB4. Now we will create the valid start and valid end also we have to give here, and foundational category K, plant GKP1, short text will give factory day celebrations. Click on the check button. You have given expenses of factory day celebrations, expenses are 10,000 rupees, and the expected value also we just give 10,000. What is the expected? Because of the limit, what will happen? If you do more than that, system will throw an error. Okay, and if you click this no limit, then you can do whatever you want to do. And then when you come to the material data and what are the details, everything is available. Okay, and if you come to delivery. See, once you give this item category B, system will automatically make it hide. It's like a display mode and without any tick mark. Whether you are using K or whatever you are using, system doesn't bother. System will directly take you to the without goods receipt because item category B behavior is like that. See, for account assignment category K, although we have kept tick mark, system least bother because item category is more preferable one. Okay, that's what I told you. Item category B useful for factory things and some rent payment. Every month they want to pay the rent. For those things, goods receipt is not at all requirement. Create a PO, do the invoice receipt, do the payment. See invoice receipts. Invoice receipt is also mandatory and it is having tick mark and also it is having what is there. Display means people cannot change it. Nobody can remove that flag for invoice receipt, and also nobody can flag goods receipt tick mark. That is the impact of item category B, and we call it, this is as a called as a blanket procurement and all. And item category B, if you use the D side D, then it will be service kind of thing we can do. And like if you are using the D service procurement, right, how we are handling that. This is the B, we call it as a limit PO, it's a blanket. Okay, now saving the PO. For this there is no concept of goods receipt. we will directly do the invoice receipt and do the payment. That's called the what you call normal or procurement, like blanket procurement. We call it as a this procurement is called as blanket procurement for electrical bills, house bills, certain kind of things. We suggest business to use this procurement process. The invoice and all normal process, like directly we give that PO number and system will ask you the details and we need to enter the values and all, we will do it. 30/11/2016 9/7 don't have any tax things, we will do it. You can open a PO in a separate screen. To see the value and all, 10th on its limit, right? How much you want to do it? The details and all will come. We'll directly do like how much amount you want to do. That we will. See, so just come to this mirror, and here give the purchase order, and with the blanket procurement, okay. Drag to right hand side and here anyway we give our tax code, which tax code you want to pay, then click on this account assignment is there, right? Click on that account assignment and give the amount, how much you want to do that limit, how much expenses were done exactly. 8000 was done, then click on check button, then click on back. See, this 8000 was copied here. Now click on tax, calculate tax, there is no tax, and give the, it's a normal process how we create invoice verification more or less. Now click on simulate. Now post it. When there is a limit, if the limit you have crossed, for example you have kept as a 10,000 in PO and if you want to try to create a 12,000 and all, then system will give a message according to the tolerance limit if you have done and whatever you have done. So this is the PO, just replicate it, you will get the respective replication and all. The purchase order history has generated, click on that purchase order history. See, this is the invoice receipt is created, then accounting people will do the payment. If you go to the follow on documents to see the accounting entries and see this vendor account get credit and the respective consumption account get debit, there will not any concept of goods receipt. This is the blanket procurement. Many of the projects we create one document type as a blanket procurement, and the document type we will allow them only item category B. Okay, see here we have right allowed item categories. When you create a purchase order, where do you make allow of, right? The configuration setting and all, we create one document type and we keep it as a blanket procurement, and in allowed item categories we make it only B. See, this blanket is already it is available. For example, if you go to allowed item categories, we make only a limit, limit as allowed. Then say we can create only a blanket procurement with that document category. That's what we do, and we will tell them if you want to pay any small expenses, you don't want to monitor goods receipt, use this procurement concept for paying rent and all those things. Okay, this is about account assignment category configuration also. Here there is an important step is there, define combination of item categories and account assignment categories. See, when you are creating the PO, you are giving item category B and K, you are giving different combinations, right? That combinations will work according to this configuration step. If you don't make a configuration step of B and K, then system will throw an error. Okay, I will test you that point and we will close for the today. See, I'm deleting B and K combination and save it just for our testing, negative testing. We call this testing as a negative testing. I'm creating a PO just now what we have done, the same thing, and I'm giving the same. Okay, what I am giving, account assignment category K and item category B. See what is the error message is coming. First error itself, combination of item category B and account assignment category K not defined, means this configuration step is having that much impact. Okay, the combinations will be mentioned here, item category B and account assignment category K. If you maintain this configuration, system won't throw that error message. Now we just replicate again ME21N and vendor GKV8. Okay, and item category, account assignment category K and item category B. Okay, now there is no error. It is giving normal test things and all. It will ask you for the limits and all. We can enter it. Okay, this is the way how account assignment category will be created, and today we learned the blanket procurement and also intra company STO. We repeated around 2-3 times because of different scenarios and all. This is use of account assignment category creation, but you have to understand we cannot create a new item category. We can create multiple account assignment category if the business needs different kind of combinations.